In order to use the AF SDK, we will first need a good understanding of, really, what AF does, how it does it, and what the object model looks like. So, we will begin by going through an example to show us, really, how AF gets built and how all of the objects look and interact. We will first create a new database to house our example here. Now, a database in AF is really just a virtual division from the rest of the world. Generally, each corporation will have one database for its production, and then maybe some number for testing. But the idea is, in production, everything goes in one database. For us, however, in this class, we are going to create ourselves a new database, specifically for our little sandbox here. Okay. So we select our database, and we go in and we see that, well, it's pretty blank. But there's a section to hold elements over here. Now, elements are the Lego pieces of AF. They are the basic building block of all things to come. And we'll get there. There's also a library of things related to those elements. For example, if we have tables of other data, if we have enumerations, or, really, if we have a template defining some of these elements. In fact, this is where we will move next, is looking at element templates. Our tank farm will be composed, really, by two types of objects, at least in the beginning. The tanks themselves, and then, really, a tank farm container to hold the tanks. So we will begin by making two element templates to define these types of objects. First, of course, a tank farm. And then we can also create a new template for tank. Now, when I'm doing this, a lot of times in System Explorer, the easiest way of getting a helpful menu is by right-clicking on an item or in an area. So this was no exception. As soon as I have templates to define my elements, I can create elements which use these templates. In fact, now we will navigate from the library over to the elements collection, and we will start making some elements. We will make a tank farm. And let me edit its name. Any element that we make, here we now have a nice shiny element. It has a name, tank farm 1 in fact, which is a tank farm. It is defined by its template. Now of course, its template is really empty right now. The template is a stub that we will enrich, but for right now, it's tied to that definition of an object. Now below this tank farm, we will have tanks. So let us make some tanks, again using this right trick click. We will make a tank. And sure enough, we have tank 1. Now I'm going to put a space in the name because that's really how my organization thinks about these items. And there you have it. We have some elements created. Now if we look at these elements a little bit further, and of course we are looking at these from the programmatic standpoint, thinking, okay, well, within an AF database, there are elements, and any given element has a name, it has a template assigned to it, and it can have a collection of child elements. Any given element also has a collection of attributes. In AF, attributes are how we bring in data to be associated with these elements. So, for example, if my tank has a level associated with it or a capacity associated with it, we will make attributes to hold that. Now this tank gets its definition from the tank template. So if we want to add any sort of data items to the definition of a tank, we need to do that in the template. So we will go back, we will look at that tank template, and here we can start adding to it. we can add an attribute which will hold capacity, and an attribute which will hold the level. Now, capacity is a constant, and level will come from a py tag. We'll configure that next, but for now, we have these stubs here, and they are ready to be configured so that any tank that I create will be able to tell me its capacity and tell me how its level is over time. We'll configure that next. So it's now time to configure these two really stub attributes in the template. Capacity of any given tank is just a constant. If it changes, we probably have big problems with the tank. So we can persist this value directly in PyAF. Now, most of my tanks are right around 3,000 gallons, so I can put in a default value in the template of 3,000 gallons, and it's 3,000 specifically. Oops. United States gallons. So that'll be the default value. If we go and look at our tank, that one tank that we've created that uses this template so far, sure enough, it gets a value of 3,000 US gallons. Now I can change that. That's fine. Life is good. But the template, of course, defines that this is going to be a number measured in gallons. Level, though, for any tank, comes from a py tag. So instead of course, persisting a scalar value directly into the Asset Framework database, we need to point to that py tag. And the way we point to the py tag is by using a data reference for that purpose, in the py point data reference. Okay, now, when we configure any data reference that here will point to the right data, let's use an example py tag. You know, we're working with tank 1 right now, just to see if this all works well, let's hard code something. Of course, we won't normally do that, but tank, something to do with tank level, there we have, tank 1 level. Okay, so just for now, we're going to hard code this. And I know that that tag is measured in percent, right? It's a level that tells me what percentage full the tank is. Measured in percent. So I'm going to tell the data reference that the raw data, the source data, is measured in units of measure of percent. So we're good. Now, of course, I want to see this data by default, predictably, in some class of unit of measure, which is really the same thing. I want to see it by default in percent. So I will configure the attribute. It's a ratio of percent. I will configure the attribute so as to show percent by default. If we go and look in one of our tanks, tank 1 correctly maps to its own py tag. We'll fix that later. But for now, we have data flowing, we have these attributes configured, one of them with a just static persisted value, and another which uses a data reference to point to data in another source or to refine it. We'll see a lot more about these data references.